morning, everybody. My name's Matt Appenzeller. I lead a organization called the Southern Ohio Chamber Alliance. We negotiate benefits for chambers of commerce so that they can offer them to their members. So really our objective is really twofold. First, obviously we want to be able to offer value-added products or cost-saving products to small employers. But then also we want to tie these programs to chambers of commerce, tie chamber of commerce membership to them. We've been doing this for, this is our 29th year. We've got 127 chambers of commerce that we deal with. We go from the Indiana border at Union City all the way to the West Virginia border at Martins Ferry, and then we go as far north as Lima and as far south as Marion. So we got a pretty wide territory there. The bread and butter of what we do is in healthcare. I brought some of my friends with me with some of our other programs. So I'm just going to zip through some of the things that we do as it relates to health plans and then turn the rest over to them. So very quickly, what was happening about 30 years ago was that metropolitan chambers were getting with large insurance carriers, health insurance carriers, and they were negotiating special rates with those carriers so that the chambers, those metro chambers, could offer them as a marketing tool for membership. Let's just say the Dayton Chamber, for example, they had an agreement with Dayton. Well, once they exhaust or saturate their marketing area, then they start going into the suburbs like Springboro, Lebanon, and out even further, and they start picking off those employers as members of their chamber. Well, in 1993, we were formed with six small chambers of commerce that offered a program through United Healthcare to compete directly with the Dayton Chamber. We offered a whopping 1% discount on health plans for small employers at that time. So things have changed quite a bit since then. I already mentioned our footprint. Basically, two-thirds of what we do is in the Dayton, Cincinnati, and Columbus region. If you include the SOCA benefit plan, which I'm going to talk about here in a little bit, we actually offer that through a competing alliance as well. We brought them underneath us for this particular plan. So we're actually offering that plan through about 285 chambers in state. So again, how do we help chambers? Our programs require chamber membership. We require that membership is maintained through the renewal, and it also gives chambers an opportunity for non-dues revenue. For the chamber, that means increased membership and member retention rates, increased non-dues revenue, and plus, you get to leverage the time and effort of people like Dale and John and Melissa and James through their benefits as well. So what we're hoping, because I used to be in AD shoes, right? I used to run a chamber. What we're hoping is that by helping to increase and retain membership, people stay engaged in their community. It's the only way you're going to grow. So here's just some of our programs that we offer here. I'm not going to go into all these because individually they're going to speak. What I am going to speak about is the SOCA benefit plan. Right. So when healthcare reform was passed and made everybody's lives easier. All right. That was my one joke for the day. Right. I'll be doing two shows in Peoria. Okay. Yeah. But anyway. So basically, here's what that law addressed. It attempted to address a very wide system. Think of it as three markets. You have the individual market on one end of the spectrum. You have large employers on the other end of the spectrum. And then in the middle, you have small employers. Well, that law addressed the individual market. And that part of it is actually working fairly well. It provided a lot of disincentives for large employers on the other end of that, and as a consequence of that, a lot of large employers went for self-funded plans or self-insured plans so that they don't have to participate in the law, basically, the community rating aspect. And then in the middle are the small employers. Choices really didn't increase at all. I mean, you basically had the same lack of choice that you always did. So it really didn't address things for small employers. I say that to say this. So we and some other interested parties helped to update a law regarding multiple employer welfare arrangements for small employers. And what this allows small employers to do, 2 to 50 employees, and then in our plan we also include sole proprietors, is that you can have a self-funded plan, or you can participate in a self-funded plan in the same way that a large employer would, except all of these small employers are pooled together into one big pool. So we started from zero on May 1st of 2016. We closed out the year with over 7,000 employers in the plan. We've got about 50,000 employees, and if you include their families, we're providing coverage now for over 100,000 people. We paid out over $375 million in claims last year, and we believe that we are running the largest MEWA in the United States, right? It's just been bizarre. But it tells you what the need is, right? The demand is clearly there, you know, for employers to take part in. I wanted to mention to you that we do this through Anthem. They're a great partner with us. They run our claims administration. And then if you hear any radio or television, see any television commercials for 844MedOhio.com, that's us. Right. So we have a toll-free number, 844-MED-OHIO. We also have the website, 844-MED-OHIO.com. If you're interested, go to that website, spell out the form, and we have 500 brokers throughout the state. We'll put you in touch with someone who you can talk to. That's what it would look like when you go to the site. So anyway, that's... I'll also say this, at the bottom there we have specialty products that are offered through the plan. So if you also wanted to get like dental and vision and maybe group life or disability through that, long-term disability, you can also purchase that. If you are a current client of the plan, you'll get a one-time credit, depending on the size of your business. Depending on how many products that you purchase, you can receive a credit of up to $8,000, but it's only a one-time credit. The Lebanon Chamber, we also offer with the Lebanon Chamber our legacy product, which is in the middle. That's the fully insured plan that we've had with Anthem for quite a number of years, and that's for employers of 2 to 50 employees. On that particular plan, that's a fully insured plan, not a self-funded plan. On that particular plan, the 1.4% premium tax that the state charges is waived. So that's why you see that 1.4% tax saving. At this point, I'm only going to cover that one benefit, but we have four of our other benefit providers who are providing benefits through or to the Lebanon Chamber through us. And first, we'll go ladies first, how's that? So I want to introduce Melissa Durham, Strategic HR. And Melissa, do you have a presentation?
Yeah.
So I don't know, is Angie here?
Yeah, Angie's right back here.
Before I hand things over to Melissa, I wanted to mention that we are a client of Strategic HR. You know, a lot of small business owners, and again, I used to be in the chamber business, right? Here's what happens to a lot of entrepreneurs. You have an idea. You worked really hard to get that idea off the ground. Lo and behold, you're selling your product or service. You're growing. You maybe hire one or two employees, and then pretty soon, I call it, as I mentioned to Melody, I call it the oh crap moment. It's the oh crap, I've got all of this other administrative stuff and HR related stuff, and I really have to think about, be very intentional about how I want my business to grow in the future. And so you need somebody like strategic HR to help you, to help do some of those things for you, help guide you through. So Melissa, the floor is yours.
Good morning, everyone. I don't know if y'all know this. I live in Lebanon. I've been here about 20 years. So very excited to be part of this organization. I've seen a lot of names that I've recognized through the years. But Strategic HR, just a little bit of background on who we are. We have been in business 27 years in May, and started in the basement of our owner's home, and they've grown. We offer, and I'll go through this in some slides real quick, some recruiting services, HR, training, so anything in that HR, and I've got my cards, actually put down my old ones, but it has our wheel on it, so I'll make sure you guys get that. So if you have any questions or we're just going to talk one-on-one, we can do a lot of consultation, really looking at what your business size looks like and really help to kind of mold what's going to work best for you. But as we grow, last May we actually merged. Our owner sold our HR services, our branding, not really our clients or anything. We still operate as a small business, so we really work with those small to mid-sized businesses. So anyone that has one employee up to 5 to 500, we can help with those different services. But we are now part of Collection for Hackett, that's our parent company. So we also offer the finance and accounting, so we have all of those services as well. But anytime you may need, just, I have an employee issue. Gosh, we did so much with COVID, helping companies with their branding, their handbooks, policies, just dealing with how to bring employees back, how to furlough, how to lay off. So we really have a lot of knowledge and just kind of reacting to some of those situations that we have. We have about 30 employees on staff now. So as I was talking to Matt, probably about 3 months ago, we had 18, so we've actually doubled. Here very recently, just as we have the needs, we get the manpower in to provide those services. So we're also HR management firm, really focusing on those small to mid-sized businesses, which is a lot of what the chambers have. You may have one employee, you may have five. So we're able to come in and help with those different services. So as you can see the wheel here in the dark, but recruitment, we have a full recruitment team that offers recruiting start to finish. So maybe
virtuals and slides for.
I was gonna say, you did a virtual with us last night.
Way too long. It's great to be in front of people. So we have brochures on, and this is what I'm gonna go through as opposed to slides if you wanna look at this. So my name is Dale Essenacher. I work for Newport Group, which is a retirement plan service provider. Right? We provide services to all types of retirement plans, 401k plans, pension plans, employee stock ownership plans, non-qualified plans, et cetera, et cetera. We've teamed up with SOCA and, of course, obviously the Lebanon Chamber to offer a new type of 401k plan. It's brand new to the marketplace as of January of last year, 2021. So it sort of ties into the health benefits, right? The health benefit program that Matt was referring to is a multiple employer wellness plan, right? So multiple companies joining one health plan for cost benefits, ease of administration, et cetera, right? So it's a lot of smaller businesses that just can't negotiate better rates with these individual insurance providers. So the government finally came around to addressing the retirement side. This is going back all the way to President Trump back in 2018. And the government kind of realizes we have a major crisis in the retirement world. There's just not enough people saving for retirement. I'll give you an example. Less than 40% of Americans have a 401k account. Less than 40%. That's pretty alarming. That means over 60% don't even have a 401k. The average balance in a 401k right now is less than $100,000. If you think about a 20, 30 year retirement, $100,000 is not gonna go very far, right? Now we obviously have Social Security. The average Social Security benefit payout right now in America is about $1,200 a month. So if you think a family, even if it's just two, right, a couple when they retire, get $1,200 a month for 25 years, they're just not gonna get there, right? So the government's panicking. They're thinking, what are we gonna do about this? So President Trump, as you can probably predict, has said, you know what, the private sector needs to work on this. The government can't solve everybody's problems, the private sector solves the problem, right? So that was back in 2018, he released something. We all were scrambling as an organization, and the other 200 or so of my competitors were scrambling. How do we do this? Well, in the meantime, Congress passed a bipartisan law called the SECURE Act in late 2019, December of 2019. They actually attached it to an appropriations bill, which was raising the debt ceiling. Everybody hears about that, right? The government's gonna shut down, we need to raise the debt ceiling. It happened again in 2019, and they attached it to this. So what the SECURE Act did is it created this new type of 401k plan, okay? And this new type of 401k plan, similar to what we already had in place, but it loosened a lot of the restrictions on who could offer the plan. It's called a pooled employer plan, okay? So similar to a multiple employer plan, they just decided to have a fancy name called pooled employer plan, or PEP. So it's really easy for me to remember because I can do PEP all day, right? So what the PEP or the new plan allowed is, again, all employers to roll up into a single retirement plan. Right? Sound familiar, right? Single benefit, single retirement plan. Very, very similar to what they did on the benefit side with the MELA. The pooled employer plan, the big difference in this legislation back in 2019 was it loosened the restrictions of who could belong. Before, you had these types of plans in the retirement world, but you had to belong to a certain association. Right, or a PEO. Now you can do it with chambers and associations within chambers and that type of thing. So loosen that restriction and allow Matt and I to have a further discussion and form this for SOCA and all its member chambers to offer to its members. So again, the pooled employer plan, very similar to MEWA, is a bunch of individual companies. Here's a couple of things that I think are unique about this. Number one, every individual company in this still has their own plan provisions. So if company A wants to offer a match to its employees in their 401k plan, they can do that. Company B doesn't want to offer a match, they don't have to do that. If one plan wants to allow their participants to take out loans out of their 401k, you can do it, but another company maybe not want to choose that. Right? So every individual employer still has their own plan wrapped up into this one big giant plan. So called an adopting employer into this pooled employer plan. Okay, so it's a little bit different in that you actually can still have your own provisions. You don't have to have a single set of provisions. So it's kind of nice in terms of, you know, a company with two or three employees might want to offer a match or even a safe harbor plan, which I don't want to get into, but it allows the owner to maximize what he saves. It doesn't really matter what anybody else saves, right? Because there's testing they have to do at the end of the year. So a company B with 15 employees might be like, you know what, I'm not offering any employer contribution. If they want to contribute, fine. So it allows you a lot of flexibility to choose what you want to choose for your retirement plan. Let me go back to some statistics that are even more alarming. So again, I talked about how many people don't have a 401k plan. So there's 52 million Americans that don't have access to a 401k, 52 million. 47% of businesses don't offer a 401k today, right? That's also gonna change very, very soon. So, and you may have seen this in the news, may not have seen this, but there's sort of this tsunami coming in the retirement world with mandates, right? And I hate to use that word, everybody's probably sick of words of mandates, but this is what's gonna happen. Like they did in the Affordable Care Act, where they made you offer a health benefit. The federal government's talking, and I'll get to the states in a minute, the federal government's talking, and it's pretty much imminent that they're gonna pass a law that's gonna make you offer a retirement plan to any employer with more than five employees. If you don't offer a retirement plan, you're gonna have to offer one. And if not, you're gonna pay fines. What does it sound like? It sounds like the Affordable Care Act, right? It's $750 fine per employee. Right, very, very familiar, right? Because the government's panicked. They're like, Social Security's gonna run out. There's only so many Walmart greeter jobs or whatever. How are these people gonna? So what they're gonna do is mandate this, right? For any employer that has more than five employees. The talk was, if they did mandate it, they were gonna give you about 9 months to set up a plan. It wasn't gonna be a year, 2 years. It was gonna be now. You have to set it up, okay? So while the federal government bickers over, right, this is bipartisan. This is both parties agree on this, right? It's passed a couple of the House of Ways and Means Committee. It passed unanimously. Everybody agrees that we have to make employers offer a plan. So while this is all going on, the states have taken it up, and the states are starting to do their own mandates. So far we have six states that have done it: California, New Jersey, New York, Maine, Oregon, and Illinois. There's 28 other states that have it in legislation, including Ohio. So California as an example, everybody has six or more employees have to offer a plan. Illinois has it at 12, Maine has it at 15. Most are somewhere around five-ish that they're talking. So very, very shortly, in the next, probably by the end of this year, the state of Ohio will have a mandate, as will the other 20 plus employers, or I'm sorry, states will have, you'll have to offer a retirement plan, some type of retirement plan. So in my brochure, and I told you I'll get this brochure, on the left-hand pocket, talks a little bit about the difference in a state-run plan versus the pool employer plan that we're offered through SOCA. Okay? And a lot of the difference is how much you can contribute, having the ability to have your own plan provisions, ease of use, et cetera, right? So there's a brochure, really simple to understand the difference between a state-run plan and a pooled employer plan that we're offering as a benefit. You can read that at your leisure. I'm more than happy to talk about that after the fact, and we can talk a little bit more. But it's coming. It's not pie in the sky. It's not trying to scare you. It's in legislation in Ohio right now. It's in legislation in Michigan. It's in legislation in Pennsylvania. So there's I think five states that don't have anything, any talks about this happening. So I think by the end of this year, you'll see almost every state have some type of mandate. My pitch to you is, why wait? Why wait until the government makes you have one? If you're talking about labor shortages and trying to recruit employees, Joe down the street has the same company you have, and you're competing for that same employee. They don't offer a plan. If you offer a plan now, which you're going to eventually have to offer anyway, maybe you have a chance to get that employee more than your competitor who doesn't have a 401k or offer a 401k plan. So a couple other things in this brochure. The last one page on the left-hand side talks a little bit about the retirement crisis that we talked about, gives you some statistics on that. I think it's very, very important. The right-hand side is really more of an in-depth about this plan, which I wanted to talk a little bit about right now, the pooled employer plan. So what are the advantages of the pooled employer plan? There's really three major advantages. part, which I always count as the third advantage, is cost. The pooled employer plan typically is about 30 to 50% less expensive than if you just went out and got a 401k plan by yourself. 30 to 40% less cost, maybe 50, sometimes I've seen 60% less cost. Very, very low cost. If you don't offer a plan today, there are tax credits for the first 3 years of offering a new plan. If you do offer a plan today, I'll do a side-by-side comparison and show you it's literally 30 to 50% less than what you're offering your employees today. The tax credits are as much as up to 50% of any cost that you would have for 3 years. Government is also talking, the federal government is talking about another piece of legislation that's talking about putting those tax credits 100% off for the first 3 years. So literally you have a plan for free for 3 years. That's not passed yet, it's up to 50% today. So if there's cost savings, right? And you can about imagine, right, the MEWA plans like that, right? The reason why you want to join together is so you can get economies of scale, and now it's like a big $100-200 million plan. Even though you're a little five-person startup plan, you get the same benefits that Apple does, which happens to be a client of ours, or Caterpillar, which happens to be a client of ours, right? So you're getting the same type of plan that they're getting in terms of a cost. So that's the first benefit. The second benefit is the ease of administration. With this 401k plan, the pooled employer plan, if you do decide to start a plan or join this, and those that have a plan, this will be music to your ears. The only thing you have to do after you set up the plan is to upload a payroll file to us for contributions for your employees every week, every other week, whatever the case may be. And at the end of the year, we're going to come back to you to answer about 8 questions so we can do testing for your plan. That's it. That's your work on this type of plan. You don't have to worry about sending out notices to employees. You don't have to worry about picking the funds. You don't have to worry about education for your employees. Nothing. The only thing you have to do is upload payroll, and if you have an outside payroll vendor, we can integrate with most payroll vendors, so you don't even have to do that part. And then, like I said, end of year 8 questions, that's it. You've reduced the 100-150 hours a year it takes to run a retirement plan down to about 20 hours. So significant reduction in administrative cost, efficiencies, et cetera, et cetera. The last, which I think, only because I'm a nerd and I'm in the industry, but the most important feature of this pooled employer plan is it significantly, almost, all but maybe 0.1% reduces and eliminates your fiduciary liability running a plan. There's a lot of rules. ERISA is what governs us by the Department of Labor. ERISA is the name of the law. There's a lot of things to remember, a lot of things to know about as a business owner to run a retirement plan, and a lot of liability that comes with that. In this plan, you shift that liability completely over to us. So we are the named fiduciary for your plan. We sign your 5500, which is your tax filing at the end of the year. We work with your participants to approve all distributions. We deliver all notices and disclosures to all participants. We do all your eligibility tracking. We do all your beneficiary forms. Everything is done on by us, and we take the liability for all those functions off your plate. It's a significant reduction, if not almost elimination, of your fiduciary responsibility, significant reduction of your operations of running a plan or administering a plan, and then, like I said, the 30 to 50% maybe higher reduction in fees than if you had your own retirement plan. So it really, again, this is brand new. SECURE Act passed in late 2019. We were able to offer this plan on January 1st of last year. The industry has seen about 3,000 companies join these types of plans in 1 year. We've seen a 30% higher sales rate last year than we've ever seen in the history of our company. Over 60% of our business comes in one of these plans today. So it's a significant kind of a watershed moment in our industry for retirement plans, and it's only going to continue to get bigger and bigger as the state mandates and the federal mandates come. So like I said, the right-hand pocket, there's a lot of details about the plan that you can read at your leisure. I'm not going to go through this. Just talks about a lot of the things that I talked about, talks a little bit about Newport Group, talks about the investment lineup that your participants can choose from, which is wide range over large cap mutual funds, small cap mutual funds. It's all listed right there. And everything else that has to do with this. If I have my card up here if you want to talk at all about this after. I'm more than happy to. I will say that I've been on a lot of national panels, webinars, and very, very well-versed in what's going on with legislation in the state as well as the federal government. If you want to talk a little bit about that, I can give you kind of the whys. Senator Portman, who you guys are very familiar with, is very, very, if not the most involved senator when it comes to this legislation. He was the one that introduced and ultimately was responsible for passing SECURE, which is what generated this plan. We talk to Senator Portman probably at least every other week as an organization. He's very much on the forefront of helping Americans retire. So he's kind of our hero because that's what we do for is help Americans retire. Just 2 seconds about us. We have about 42,000 companies that use Newport as a retirement service provider, a little over 2 million participants, and about $400 billion that we have under administration at Newport across the entire country, ranging from, like I said, the Caterpillars and the Apples of the world, all the way down to startup one-person, single employer plans. We do those as well. So any size company, we do. I think we're going to take questions at the end, right? Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, that's good. Good. So actually, let me make a quick comment here with Dale and his group. Again, just like he said, you know, we felt like this was an opportunity for us to address a real world problem where people are not, you know, saving enough for retirement, and not enough employers have a mechanism for them, right? So, you know, at the time, none of this legislation was, well, it was being talked
coming,
about, but yeah, it wasn't nearly as, it wasn't imminent like Dale is saying now, but, you know, we just felt like we would put this marker down and see where it develops and clearly it started. So, thanks, appreciate it. But at this time, I'm going to actually turn things over to you, have the clicker, right? Okay. To John Webb from Elevon. They do our payment processing and other point of sale systems. John was very busy in the early parts of the shutdowns and whatnot. So John, the floor is yours.
All right, thank you. So the first thing I'd like to say is that we are owned by U.S. Bank, but U.S. Bank owns Elevon, which is global processor. So we have clients all over the world. Our largest clients are Hilton and Delta, but obviously those are not my clients. I work with small businesses, you know, like everybody in here essentially. And but it's very important to know that it is a freestanding product, and you do not have to bank with U.S. Bank in order to take advantage of this benefit that we offer through, you know, SOCA and the chamber. So we can deposit the funds into whatever bank that you have. We would love to have you at U.S. Bank, and Sam can talk to you about that at some point in time, maybe. But it's not a requirement. You know, basically, it is, you know, are you paying too much for your current processing, or are you not current in, you know, regulations, or are you not streamlined in, you know, how you collect payments? One of the things I like to say is you never want to put your business in a position where you can't collect payments from the customers the way they want to pay you, and that's ever-changing, you know, every single day. I ran across the client that we've had for 10 years, and just yesterday, and you know, they've never called in, or you know, so you think they're happy, you know, or whatever, they've used this forever, but you got to imagine that we're doing things a million times different today than what we were 10 years ago. So it's great to have that longevity of clients, but you also have to kind of keep up on things as well too. So what do people say about U.S. Bank? The top one, the world's most ethical companies. We also won that in 2020. 2021 as well. So 7 years in a row, the world's most ethical bank. You typically don't hear bank and ethical in the same sentence, but we win award after award, you know, for that. So we're super proud of that. You know, as far as I'm concerned, MasterCard rated number one for reliability. If you're looking for somebody to be reliable with your credit card processing, you know, that means a lot for you. Why Elavon? You know, we've been processing since 1991, the fourth largest processor in the nation. We have over a million customers, you know, under our belt. So we have a solution for every single person, and nothing is cookie cutter. You know, there's a lot of businesses out there, you know, that fit into like a, you know, like an equal-sided box, you know, kind of like a square, I guess, that offer a single product and hope that it fits your particular business, okay? We use a customized approach to, consultative approach to figure out what works best for you and your particular business. These are some of the things that we offer. POS systems, we actually own our own POS. So when you go in and buy your hamburger and french fries, you know, from somewhere, it prints up in the kitchen or for retail, we actually sell those. We make them, we sell them, we program them, I train you on them, I'm your support afterwards. We do the whole nine yards. Regular terminals, mobile from the person who just has a hair salon and runs $100 a month through their mobile phone. We offer that for our customers as well too. Drivers, you know, for your, you know, installers or people who are collecting, you know, out there, we can do that as well too. This is very important. A lot of people think of us as the credit card guy, and that's not true. I don't just put a machine in front of you and say, here you go, go ahead and collect your credit cards. I hope this works for you. This is a list of all the different things that I do for our customers to help them run their business more cost efficient and more effectively. You know, obviously credit cards, debit cards, POS systems are on there, Bluetooth terminals, pay and table, you know, solutions, online ordering, pay now buttons or donate now buttons for nonprofits, for instance. Website integrations, we can integrate into any website out there whatsoever. We have medical software to where we can incorporate into any patient management system, and when they're ready to collect the payment, the window pops up, they collect their credit card payment, and it automatically posts back to the patient management system. That is huge nowadays. Billing and invoicing, you know, one of the big guys out there, QuickBooks with Intuit, we can do that the same as they can with a lot more savings, basically, associated with it. And no funds holding, we deposit daily, we don't hold any funds at all. Inventory management, another big one, top right, zero cost credit card processing, that's becoming more and more popular right now. And what that is that's surcharging. So if you've been approached to go pay by a business and they're like, hey, we have to tack on this surcharge in order to cover the credit card processing, we have that, we offer it through there if that's a choice that you as a business want to make. And it just passes that fee on to the customer. It's certainly a decision, you know, that you have to make, quite frankly. I will tell you that we started doing it about 2 years ago when it became legal in Ohio again, and not one customer that I know of here in Ohio has switched back from surcharging after they started surcharging their customers. It has become accepted that's, you know, that's a normal way of business. And as you see down here, funding into any bank, okay? So you don't have to be associated with U.S. Bank at all. Basically, we just like to take a look at your two most recent statements so we can get an idea of how, what kind of transactions you run. Much like a roofer, you can't call up a roofing company and say, hey, how much is it to put a roof on my house? how big is your house? How many square foot? How tall is it? What's the pitch of the roof? I know a couple words. You know, do you want tile? Do you want 10-year, you know, shingles? Do you want 20-year shingles? You know, we have to come out there. We have to measure. We have to give you, you know, what's perfect for your house. Same thing on your business. We have to figure out what's your average sale. What's your, you know, how are you collecting? How do you want to collect? Have you thought about collecting this way? And then we can come in and give you an itemized or a customized, you know, solution just for your particular business. And the pricing is going to be customized as well too, you know, through the chamber discount program, not a one size fits all, unless that's what you want. If you want a flat rate, you know, like a square, then we can do that as well, even better than the way. That's it. I wanted to keep mine a little bit short for you guys. If you have any questions, you can reach out to me, you know, afterwards. So, thank you.
Awesome. Thanks, Joe. Just a quick note about John, your first one looks very hard. Does a really good job. When the lockdowns hit, you know, we're in the chamber business, so it's like, you know, in your mind, you're thinking every small employer is infected or affected in some way. And John was busy helping a lot of them were like food restaurants and whatnot who had never had any sort of ordering system online. And so this is the guy they call so that, you know, some of those restaurants could at least do curbside pickup. And you know, if you're never, you know, you never think of the pandemic going to happen and shut down a restaurant, right? So, but John was very busy during that time trying to get that done.
And now everybody does curbside pickup and online ordering and things like that. The other big one was churches. Churches who passed the collection plate and then all of a sudden nobody's going to church. Churches were really hurting, and so we worked diligently to get them donate now buttons right on their websites and on their Facebook pages and set up that auto recurring so that even though people are going to church, you're still required to tithe, you know, and so we got that up and running for churches, you know, super quick. So
think of how many churches are just in love and alone.
And they still have a mortgage, right? They still have to pay their expenses.
There you go. Okay, so our next person presenting is James Baker with the Hunter PEO. So Hunter Consulting is a company that we've done business for workers' comp group rating for a number of years. They actually have a self-insured a plan for workers' comp that I'll let James tell you. So TeamWorks, the floor is yours, TeamWorks.
Thank you. Glad to be here, guys. Good morning, I'm James Baker from TeamWorks, and really enjoy what I do at TeamWorks. You guys may know that workers' comp is an interesting thing in Ohio. For the state of Ohio, there's four states where you have to go through the state of Ohio for your workers' comp. You can't bring in insurance companies to quote your workers' comp, and that can be a problem for some companies, because if you're in a risky industry, you might be paying a heck of a lot more than you should be on your premiums. And what we've done at Hunter is we are a PEO, a professional employer organization, where we are a company designed to allow employers to run their workers' comp through our self-insured program instead of their state fund program. And there could be a significant savings for these employers that actually do that. So doing here. Now nobody's here from Hunter, so I'm not going to do a whole other 15-minute presentation on Hunter, but we'll just do one quick page to give them to let you guys know who Hunter is. They've been around since 1986. I think you give Love a Bad Name by Bon Jovi was playing the radio when they decided to do business. So they've been around a long time. And the interesting thing about these guys is they still have employees that are original employees that have been there since 86. I've been there 5 years, and I'm like the young pup. There's a bunch of people that have been there 20 years, 15 years, who just, they love what they do, they love what they work for, and it works out really well. So what are we doing over at Hunter? We are a third-party administrator for workers' comp, so when there's a claim filed against an employer, there to represent the employer to say, no, this claim's not correct, we're fighting this, you know, we're going to fight this claim. We're also involved with grading and a bunch of other things. We're here in Cincinnati, here down in Cincinnati, I should say, not here. And we have around 30 employees in Hunter. So one of our clients is I'm a classmate. But so what are we doing here? When claims occur, we're sending attorneys to these hearings. And folks really like working with us. Okay. So we are an expert. Hunter is an expert in the, especially in the self-insured workers' comp administration. The larger employers, the largest employers are self-insured, the P&Gs, the General Electric. They pay their own claims. And so we manage that, we medically manage that whole process. And what we decided to do back in 2014 is create a PEO, Professional Employer Organization. It's mainly run by Hunter personnel. So basically what you do is, and you can do this in all 50 states, but it's very unique in this state, is you can take your current existing workforce and run the payroll, the taxes, and in this case the workers' comp, under our federal ID instead of their own. We actually become an administrative employer for our client. They give us the ability to pay their taxes on their behalf through our umbrella instead of their own. I know it's confusing, but it's been going on for many years. The IRS is cool with it. So as long as that's the case, and the Bureau of Workers' Comp is as well, then we're going to proceed forward. So what we're doing here is we are self-insured, so that is our niche in our marketplace. So what that means is, if there's a construction company out there that has maybe 50 or 100 employees, they're probably paying a very good sum of money for workers' comp, whether they have claims or they don't. And so what we're trying to do is get these employers to hire us and save potentially tens of thousands of dollars net per year by being our client. So those are the folks I'm looking for. Those are larger employers. They're typically blue-collar employers because they are producing the most premium. You know, we're talking roofers, anybody in the construction world. And so what we're trying to do with employers is just get them to agree to a review. Let's see how much savings is out there for you. And, you know, $50,000 in savings might appeal to, you know, person A, but person B may say, it's not worth my time. So we're willing to do that. We're willing to actually run the numbers. We do a 6-year look back on companies and take a look and see. And be interested to see, like, I found one company was paying $200,000 premium, pretty big employer, up in Springfield. 600 employee printing company, and found out that they were only averaging around $12,000 claims cost per year, and they're paying $200,000. So those are the type of employers I'm really looking for. People walk in and cut their rate in half, save them $100,000 before they even think about what happened. And what's nice is you're basically funneling everything through one company. So you've got got a payroll company right now. You have to get run through our payroll company. They're awesome. The whole idea of switching payroll is not appealing to a lot of people, but we do all the work, so it's really nothing to be concerned with. It is a hurdle sometimes. People are never excited about this part of what we do, but if they know how much savings is at the end of the rainbow, then it might be. But think about right now as a company. If they have a problem with your payroll, you have to call your payroll company. You have trouble with the IRS, you got to deal with the IRS. Job and Family Services, so if you have a problem with unemployment, you got to deal with that huge entity. Bureau of Workers' Comp, Managed Care Organization, Third Party Administrator, if you have a workers' comp, and there's three layers just in one. You know, safety with OSHA, you might get OSHA clients. Homeland Security Division, the people of legal status. So to be able to funnel all of this through one company, it's going to make the HR director, if there is one, their life a lot easier. They actually look at us and they're a little bit threatened, I think, a lot of times. And maybe not so much sometimes, but the other times it's like, well, I've already deal with people I know and like and trust. So it's sort of a big ask to ask them to just wipe all that off and deal with us. But once they do that, they're like, wow, it's much easier to call one company for all of these issues. So you're going to make their life easier, you're going to save the company money. Some of our clients, so we work with some roofing companies, trucking companies. OKI Interiors is on, that's one of our largest clients. They've got about 300 employees. So the larger you are, the more savings that you will achieve in the 2 years. So this isn't going to be for everybody. And if there's somebody who we can't save money, but they're interested in this, we can definitely help them as well. It all revolves around workers' comp and allowing that initial review to happen.
That's good for you.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, James.
I'm last, so I don't want to make it a 20-minute presentation.
So we've had a relationship with Hunter Consulting Conservative. So you know, they have the group, workers' comp group rating program, and then they have the Teamworks company as well. But we've had a relationship with them since 1996. They're not unlike a lot of small businesses here. It's actually two brothers who are actually running the company.